Hello guys, welcome back. In this React with the Jest video tutorial, we are going to learn how we can test the functions and state with a Jest in React.js. So let's get started. In the last video, we just learned how we can set up the Jest with the React.js and just run a simple snapshot test case. So if you are not watched this, you can watch this. The link is given in the description. And now let's start it. So this is our we can say that app.js, and here I have a function with the name of like handle test, and it will take a value with the data, and it will return data into true. Alright, so that means if I am going to pass it here 10, then it will return the 20. So how I can test this function? So for now I am going to write a test. So this is our last test case, so I am going to remove the unnecessary things. So alright, so I am going to write here function and state test. So I just create a I need a render.create.application, and I have to use the getInstance function. GetInstance function will give you the all state props. We can basically say that it will provide the whole instance to the variable. So here I can use like I can take a variable with the result. So I'm going to write here tree. Dot my function name. What is my function name? Is handle test. So for that handle test, I can write here and I can pass here some values, like I pass just 10 here. So I can check here console dot log result. So what I'm getting here, this is just for debugging. If you want to use, then you can use, otherwise you can skip it. So expect, and what is I'm expecting the result to be, what is to be will provide the matching value. So I'm going I want to 20, because I pass here 10, then most probably the result should be 20, and this, if the result is not 20, then our test case will be fail. So if you are thinking that why I am going to pass a static value, then you can use a constant file and you can pass the variable values from here. If you don't want to, just simple, because this is just simple and basic tutorial, that's why I'm just passing the constant values here, simple values here. Okay, so now just run it and test it. So npm test. And let's see what's going on. So okay, so I have to, you can see that when there is a one obstacle, because the snapshot is not matching with that in the last files. If I'm going to pass just okay, so now you can see that we have one test case and we got the passed it, and the console dot result is 20 here. The result is given by here. So, and if I am going to pass here like anything else, like I pass 290, then it case will be failed. It will tell you that the expected value that you are using is 290 and we receive the 20. So if this is asking that the value should be 290, not be 20, which is we are passing here. So because you can see that we receive here 10 multiply by 2, so it simply be 20. It cannot be 290. That's why it will telling that we received 20, but you are trying to match with the 290. This is wrong. That's why our test case failed. If I'm going to write here it's 20 and it should be matched with the 40, because it's multiplied by 2, then you can see that the test case is run here. So this is a way how we can test the function. So now see how we can test the states. So for that I need a state. So you can take a constructor here, pass a super and take this dot state, and it could be, let's take a state with the val, and I just pass 0 to the val. So in this function, so let's say I will update my state, this dot set state, and I can pass here val equal to data. That means what we are going to pass in the parameter. Alright, so here I'm going to come back here, and now I have to check that not to the result. I will just use it here and I will check their result dot state. I can check here two times, once before the our function, and I can write here before update, and there it should be 0, and after that I'm going to write here after update, so it should be 20. So I'm going to check here tree dot state dot val, and you can write here state dot val also here, state dot val, otherwise you will get the old states, should be 20. Why? Because we're passing here 20. So let's check here. Okay, result is not defined here, so actually I can take here like tree dot state. This is not result here. Alright, so now you can see that before the state is, before update it's 0, after update it's 20, and the test case is running successfully because we passed here 20. If I get passed state equal to 10, then it's going to fail because we expect the 10 but we receive the 20. Why? Because we passed here 20 in this function and we got here the value of parameter here, and we in the parameter we got the 20. That's why it's failed. If I am going to just pass here 10, then it should be fine. You can see that now it's fine. So this is a basic video about how you can test the functions and states in the Jest with the in the React with the Jest test cases. So if you have any kind of confusion, you can ask me on the comment box. You can like us on the Facebook. The description is given in the description box. And if you want the example code, then the GitHub link is also given in the description box. Thanks guys. Thanks for watching this video. Don't forget to subscribe, the like, and don't forget to subscribe the channel and like the video. Thanks guys.